Live from the north side of Chicago, Wrigley Field. A great night for baseball ahead on the show. It's the Miami Marlins and the Chicago Cubs. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about ready to go. And on the hill in this one, Jameson Taillon.
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way, because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat them.
Luis Arraez stands in.
Luis Arraez.
Left-hand hitter waits. That's in there, and it's one and two.
He's dealing with a great two-strike hitter right here. The strikeout is not automatic.
Give it up, Marlins. And that skips in the dirt. Just missed off the outside edge.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Outside, and that is ball four. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
Here's Tim Anderson. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Bellinger grabs it on the run. And time now for the Marlins lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These players have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Squeezes it out, number two.
Batting fourth, the third baseman, Jake.
On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Here's a big power threat, Jake Berger. And a 2-1 on the way. Foul ball.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Two outs. Got him looking. And that is that. Marlins leave one. And now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Here at the friendly confines. And starting this one, Max Meyer.
Well, it's a three-pitch mix in the repertoire for this starter. He's going to have to command all three if he's going to have success on the hill today.
Here's Nico Hoerner.
Leading off.
He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. And that's off the inside edge. And a count, 2-1. There's a strike.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
The wind of the pitch. Line drive caught. Time now for the Chicago Cubs lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Into center. Chisholm makes the grab, two down.
Batting third, the center fielder.
Two outs, base is empty. And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. Two outs, base is empty. Just missed. That one misses, and that's ball three. Seiya Suzuki on deck for the Cubs. Fouled off to the right. Two down, nobody on. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
That misses the zone, and that's ball two. Bellinger leads off first with two down to the inning. Runner on the go. Hammers that one deep left field and forget it. He'll circle the bases and they jump out front. It's 2-0.
That's a fun way to take the lead. Just hit one out of the park. Sure, there's a big grin on his face right now, Boog. He's probably had some of those that didn't stay fair, but off the bat, it looked like it was going to bend foul. He was able to keep it in there, tucked it nicely, and he gets the jog around the bases. Good for him.
Dansby Swanson stands in. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Cubs add two on this homer, and it's 2-0. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Second inning set to go. Jazz Chisholm Jr. now.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
And a 1-2. Hard hit to third. In time to Bush. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
Batting six. The left fielder.
Ryan De La Cruz getting ready to hit. Swing, and that's ripped towards right center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two down.
Batting seven. The right fielder, number 12.
And at the plate for Miami, Jesus Sanchez. Two outs. Inside just missed.
I think it's very important to establish the inside part of the plate early. Sets the tone for the rest of the game.
Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Suzuki has a beat on it. He's there. He's got it. And that is that. here at Wrigley Field, ready to go for the last half of the inning. So up now for Chicago, Ian Happ.
Happ, a switch hitter. It can be challenging for guys at the big league level to maintain a good swing from both sides of the plate. Clearly, he's got more pop from the left side, but in 2022, the right side was respectable as well.
One and two now. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly.
He's safe.
Leadoff man aboard on the air, and that puts your pitcher in a little bit of a tough spot right away to start the inning, not where you want to be. So we'll see if he's able to work around it and pick the defense up.
And next for the Cubs, Christopher Morel. That one ripped. Could be extra bases. Headed for the plate. He'll score easily. It's 3-0. That ball was absolutely ripped. 111 off the bat. And I'm pretty sure it started to whistle after it left the bat.
I think I heard that too, Boog. And these are the moments we appreciate when we can look at StatCast and just see exactly what the data is. Always so much fun to see what numbers pop up.
Now it's Yan Gomes. Next one misses. Now two balls and a strike. Man at second. Wouldn't ball chase three. That time. Ed Drummond, our umpire behind the plate in this one.
Yeah, Boog, he's a really fair umpire, both the pitchers and the hitters. So standard strike zone, he's consistent with it. And the great thing is you don't see players questioning the calls too much. So that's a good thing in this day and age.
And the right-hander deals. And that one off the inside edge. You walked him.
So here we go again with the walks. It's been a real struggle finding the zone for him in the past. Now, even if they get out of this jam, these walks add pressure and stress to the entire team.
Fastball for a strike. One and two.
Big at bat right here with an opportunity to do damage. But on the flip side, ground ball, double play, strikeout. That could get the inning back under control on the mound.
And a pitch. This to third. Nice stop. Throws from his knees. There's one out there, but that's all they'll get.
Up next to the cut.
Just a beautiful play right there to get it out. He dives to make the stop. Then a nice feed from his knees. Knew he didn't have time to get up and make that throw. The throw beats the runner. That's that internal clock working.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. The batter now, Nico Hoerner. Late on that fastball.
One ball, two strikes.
Runners are at the corners, one away. And another ball.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience, not going outside the strike zone.
Righty to the plate. Fights it off, you'll see another. Base hit and a run in to score. Lead runner around second to third. The tag out.
That's heads up play right there. The outfielder knowing he has no shot at the runner at home, so comes up trying to cut that runner off at third and does a really nice job. Gotta appreciate that.
Here's Mike Tauchman. Ball and a strike. The pitch. That one to first. It's in and out of his glove. But he wins the foot race to first. Good job of knowing how much time he had there. So two runs on two hits, one error, and one left on base. We play two full. It's the Cubs 4 and the Marlins nothing. New inning getting started. Avisail Garcia up to the plate.
Avisail Garcia.
Kicks and fires. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. The 1-2. Knocks that one away and we'll do it again.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Kicks and deals. Got him looking, and he didn't like the call.
No, that's not the best two-strike fastball I've seen, but certainly got away with the location there. You know, sometimes as a hitter, when you're down in the count, you're so focused on a pitcher painting the black, and you just get a little bit locked up on something down the heart of the plate, not expecting it, and it just kind of freezes you. Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Wouldn't chase that time. The Cubs leading by 4. We're here in the top half of inning number 3. Swing and a miss as he was late. The pitch. Fair ball. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. The throw in. And the throw's offline, safe at third.
You know, I was watching his rounds during batting practice today. So impressed with his ability to let the ball travel, go back up the middle and the other way. Sometimes when you step in the box during the game, you get a little anxious and you get away from that. But so far, I've seen him stay consistent with his pregame preparation.
Next to hit, Tim Anderson. Though Chris through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. On the inside corner for a strike. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressive. Lifted in the air out to left. Hat moving under it. Brings it in. Runner tagging from third. The throw is offline and he's in to score. It's 4-1.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play and a nice job with the sac fly.
Here's Josh Bell. Arise off of first with two away. That one clubbed out towards left center. That'll be extra bases. Around third. Relay throw home. It's offline. The run comes in, and it's now a two-run game.
Well, that gets him a little closer in this one. Got a fastball, middle of the plate, jumped all over it. Absolutely smoked that ball.
And now for the Marlins, Jake Berger. And another ball.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
The next offering misses. 3-1. Jazz Chisholm Jr. up next. Here comes a pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Man on second, two down. In the air, foul off first. Brings it in, and that is that. They put two on the board with a couple of hits, no errors, and one left. We move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Cubs 4 and the Marlins 2. Set for the bottom of the third, here's Cody Bellinger.
The center fielder.
So Cody Bellinger went as a fourth-round pick by the Dodgers in the 2013 draft. How about this, though? His final year in high school, he hit just one home run.
You know, these Cubs doing a good job of putting the ball into play, and that makes things more challenging on the defensive side. They're hitting everything thrown at them. Their contact rate is in the low 90s. It's like they know what's coming, and that's just pretty ridiculous what they're doing right now. Those numbers are well above the major league average.
That one missed.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning, so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
The wind of the pitch. To the right side, and that squirts through. He forced a lot of pitches to be thrown and ends up collecting a hit.
Just one of those at-bats you almost hate to see come to an end. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock, and we'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole.
Seiya Suzuki, the next Cub to hit. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. At the belt and fires. And another ball. And the right-hander's 3-1. Turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline. Righty delivers. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Gets a piece and stays alive. Three and two now. Got him. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
No, you know, that's got to be very frustrating for this guy. He knows the strike zone extremely well, and you know what? Good hitters are not going to compromise. He'll take that punch out, but ultimately stick with his plan and have more success than anything else.
Now it's the shortstop, Dansby Swanson. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts, so they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
He and half up to hit. Two outs. Fastball almost got him there. The pitch. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Christopher.
So two down, Christopher Morel, the next Cub to hit. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Here comes a 3-2. Got him. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one. Cubs strand a couple as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. And we're back. Start of the fourth, and at the plate for Miami, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Left-hand batter waits. Fastball in for a strike. Now 1-2.
They must have been looking for something else because he gave up on that pitch a little early. It was right down Main Street. Probably not going to see a better pitch to hit in this at-bat.
Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat-out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Swing and a high fly ball left field. Pat pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Up next for the Marlins, the right fielder,
Jesus Sanchez, digs in now. Two down, nobody on. And another ball. Hey. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. The Marlins trailing by two, top half of inning number four. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The pitch. Fouls it back with two strikes. Two outs. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. The wind and the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. And the Marlins down quietly. Still down by a count of 4-2. Back here at Wrigley Field, John Ciampi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Yan Gomes. Now two balls and a strike.
Not a lot of people know this, but this isn't the only Wrigley Field in MLB history. You know, when the league expanded and added the Los Angeles Angels in 1961, they played their first season at a stadium in L.A. called Wrigley Field, which had been the home of the minor league team of the same name.
And Gomes is retired.
Now batting, the first baseman, Michael Bush.
And now the first baseman, Michael Bush. breaking ball inside. And it's 2-1. Miami's bullpen with some action. Vladimir Gutierrez up and loosening in the pen. Sanchez, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. One down, base is empty. And that's in for a strike. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Base is empty, one away. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. And that's downed away. This to center field. Sizes this one up. Hauls it in for the out. And there are two outs.
The batter, number two.
Here's the second baseman, Nico Horner. That one way inside. On the line, base hit.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Mike Tauchman, the next Cub to hit.
Two balls.
And a pitch out, but no steal, and it's ball two. The 2-1.
Three balls, one strike.
Cody Bellinger waiting to hit for the Cubs. Horner off of first with two away. Runner on the goal, and that's too high. Ball four.
We'll just keep handing out gifts, Boo. Were we supposed to bring something?
See, I think just our presence is the present. Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Max Meyer won't go any further. 2-1 ball game as he heads for the dugout, and we'll be back with a new pitcher. New pitcher for the Marlins, Vladimir Gutierrez.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Bellinger up to hit. Fought off foul. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Well, needed a big strikeout to get out of danger. Turned into deception, that changeup. Great execution. Really sold it with the arm speed. Had his opponent way out on that front foot.
Ready now for the fifth inning. And now the DH, Abisail Garcia. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Perfect.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
And yep, another ball, double-barreled action in the bullpen. Julian Merriweather up and throwing for manager Craig Counsell. Number 43, a lefty, warming up as well. Runner at first with no outs here. And the pitch. On the ground, a second, might be two. Off balance feed, there's one. Over to first, safe.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Drew Smiley into the game.
Still pretty early in the ball game, so this bullpen has some work ahead of him. Best case scenario might be if he can come in here and get several quick outs, kind of bridge the gap that starter left for him.
Now it's the Marlins leadoff hitter, Luis Arraez. 2-2 down. On the ground, a second, might be two. Gathers and throws to first. Got him.
The bat, number seven.
And up next for Miami, Tim Anderson. Runner at second, two down. And we're at the top of the fifth. Base knock center field. Rounds third, headed for the plate. Now a long throw home. He scores. It's 4-3.
Well done. Drives in the run. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
And now the switch hitting first baseman Josh Bell. Here's a 1-1. Way inside. Two outs. Wouldn't That's chase that time. Three Jake balls, Berger, the kind of bat that can make a big impact if they can keep it going here. Snap throw to first. And he's back in safely.
I think you want to get a one-way lead, be very aggressive in the secondary. This hitter not a power guy, so you want to make sure that you can get some length on the secondary lead and perhaps score a ball in the gap.
Yeah, there's ball four.
The batter, the third baseman, Berger.
Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jake Berger. Two on, two outs. A little out front there as he swings through it.
One ball, two strikes.
A 1-2. And another ball.
2-2 now.
Got him swinging.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
And welcome back to the ballpark. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Seiya Suzuki.
Well, here's a fun fact for you, Boog. Suzuki is the first Japanese-born player to homer in three consecutive plate appearances in the majors.
One ball.
Feel free to use that note in your next Cubs broadcast, buddy.
Swings and misses, struck him out.
Well, that was a tough slider right there. He couldn't get a piece of it just to try to keep the at-bat alive. And hitters will tell you that slider, when a guy's able to really tunnel the pitch where it looks like a fastball and then late has really good bite, so tough to lay off of because you've made the decision you don't want to get beat by a fastball, and then you swing and you miss, and you go back to the dugout shaking your head.
Not in time, and he reaches safely.
Not every base hit is a liner into the gap, just like not every strikeout's a perfect slider down and away. I mean, right there, he just put the ball in play on the ground and gave it his all to get down to first for the ninth.
Man at first with one gone. Ian Happ, the next Cub to hit. On the ground, could be two. Throws to second for one. Return throw to first, got him. Double play, and that'll do it. One hit in the inning, but no one left. We're through five. It's the Cubs four and the Marlins three. Here at Wrigley Field, top of the sixth inning. And now the center fielder, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Whips it to first on the run. Now one gone in the top of the sixth.
Now back.
And now for the Marlins, Brian De La Cruz. The Cubbies up by a run, and we're in the top half of the sixth. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Bellinger tracks it down for the out.
Man, that's one of those at bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at bat.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. And that's downstairs and outside.
Two balls, two strikes.
Hacks and misses, it's a strikeout. No runs, no hits, no errors. 7-8-9, two up in the home half of the inning. It's the Cubs four and the Marlins three. Back here at the friendly confines, here's the third baseman, Christopher Morel. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the position because when you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole team that much better.
And that's outside. And it's 3-2. What about playing another position on defense, one that would require a little more range?
Absolutely.
Down the line. Sanchez on the run. Tries to make the play, but it's foul. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Center field. Under it. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
Now batting. The catcher. Yan.
Here's Yan Gomes.
Yo.
Base is empty, one away here in the bottom of the sixth. And a foul ball. And a pitch. A little bit high. 2-2.
It's a good take.
And another ball. One down, base is empty. And he walked him.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk.
And here's the first baseman, Michael Busch. And here it comes. To the right side. Bell over to second. What a double play that was. Inning over. Offense held a check there. We're through six full. It's the Cubs 4 and the Marlins 3. All set for the start of the inning. And now, Abisail Garcia. Looking to get the tying run on base. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. And there's a ball. Movement in the Cubs bullpen. Adbert Alzola getting ready to go. Leiter warming up as well. Caught him looking for the K. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
Christian Bethencourt, the next up for the Marlins. The 1-2. Bounce to the left side. And foul ball. That misses the zone. And it's 2-2. Holding on to a one-run lead here in the top half of inning number 7. Got him swinging. That's out number 2.
A pretty good break on the curveball right there. Maybe not as down in the zone as he would have liked, but deceptive enough to get that swing and miss. And if you don't catch that pitch out front on the barrel, it bears in on you pretty hard.
So the batting order turns over. Now it's the Marlins leadoff hitter, Luis Arraez. And another ball. Swings through that one out in front that time. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And it's a 3-up, 3-down inning. Miami down in order. Score holds at 4-3. Bottom of the seventh. Here's the Cubs leadoff man, Nico Hoerner.
Second baseman.
In for a strike. Gonna count 1-2. And a pitch. And that one is in the dirt. The count now 2-2. Fights it off, you'll see another. The pitch. Got him looking. Froze him with the heater at the knees.
Well, just excellent location on that inside fastball. Really locked him up. And as a hitter, it's not typically what you're looking for. You're trying to protect away and then in, so you can be a little bit tardy with two strikes. Hard to tell if he was fooled or if he thought it would be called a ball, but either way, that's a really nice pitch.
So now the DH spot, Mike Tauchman. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. That one to first. Bell takes it to the bag. Two up, two down.
The center fielder, number 24, Cody Bellinger.
And up next for Chicago, Cody Bellinger.
Hey.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Man, this has been a real important inning in relief. I mean, so far, they've been doing a great job holding that deficit at one.
Fouls it off, still 1-2. Two down, nobody on. Here, the bottom of the seventh. Battling here as he fouls it away. And another ball. Here's the 2-2. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Three up, three down. Inning over. Nothing happening there for the Cubs. And it remains a 4-3 game. Welcome back. And a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Advert Alzolay.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different. So we'll see what he's got here.
Ball to strike. That's to third, and he grabs it in foul ground. And the righty deals. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Hector Neris up and throwing for manager Craig Counsell. A strikeout.
Pretty big strikeout right there to start this eighth inning. Down one. Any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture a run to needing to run into something or just try to string multiple hits together to get a run across the plate.
Josh Bell at the plate now. One down, base is empty. Just missed. Pitch on the ground, right side corner, in plenty of time to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Jake Berger, trying to hold a one run lead, and we're in the top of the eighth. And 1-2.
Well, no signs of wavering on the mound here in the eighth. It's looking rock solid so far.
That's off the mark, and it's 2-2. Wouldn't chase that time. Jazz Chisholm Jr. waits on deck for Miami. This one driven deep, way back there, and it's gone. We are tied. That fire up the dugout, and we are starting over. It's 4-4.
Wow, what a clutch swing right there. And now anything can happen in this game. What an incredible momentum swing on that home run, Boog. I mean, it's late in the game, just barely stayed fair. That ties up the ball game. Impressive.
Two outs, nobody on. Digging in, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Good eye right there. And a pitch. That one misses. Now 3-1. Brian De La Cruz in the on deck circle. The 3-1. Lifted in the air, right field. That gets down for a hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Now that one, left fielder.
Ryan De La Cruz now at the plate. Here's a rocket out to left. He's got it. And that's the third out. But this clutch home run gets us even again. It's now tied 4-4. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here at Wrigley Field, ready for the bottom of the eighth. So now it's the Cubs hitter in the four hole, Seiya Suzuki. Right-handed reliever. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there.
That front door slider is such a devastating pitch. You don't want to get beat by the inside fastball, so you cheat a little bit, and then by the time it gets there, it's out of the swing plane.
Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
You know, Boog, you often think of sliders more for that horizontal movement, but most of the good ones have both vertical depth and that horizontal movement, and that's what we saw right there. Good drop on the break and got him to swing over the top.
Next to hit, Dansby Swanson. The 1-2. The shortstop takes a ball.
Two balls, two strikes.
And he deals. Misses. And it's a full count. Ian Happ waits on deck. All tied up here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Outside, and that is ball four.
The left fielder, number 8.
So up now for Chicago, Ian Happ.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Tied at 4. Here's a strike.
With 2 strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Signs of activity in the pen for the Marlins. A left-hander appears to be getting ready. One and two here. Got him! And now 2 gone.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically he likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
So up next, Christopher Morel. You talk about the power and the speed together.
Well, we knew he was going to be a stud just coming up, making his way through the minor leagues, and quickly at this level, an impact player.
And another ball.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
That one is absolutely belted. Way back there. Into the bleachers and gone. That should get the dugout going. It's 6-4. Listen to these fans.
This place is absolutely buzzing right now. You can feel the energy all the way up here in our broadcast booth. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So two down, Yan Gomes, the next Cub to hit. Next offering is downstairs. Yan Gomes waits. Foul ball there.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Two down, nobody on. Base hit.
Now batter, first baseman, Michael.
And next for the Cubs, Michael Busch. Two outs. Hit hard, that gets through. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
The batter, number two, second baseman.
So the Marlins go with a new arm, Andrew Nardi.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
And here is Nico Hoerner. The pitch. Chase that time.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Two on, two outs, and that's ball four.
Oh, this is their chance to break it open. If they don't end up winning this ball game, they're going to look back at this opportunity right here and have some regret.
So digging in, Mike Tauchman.
Well, he's so good about trying to drive the ball to the opposite field gap in these situations. If he takes that approach, he could bust this game wide open.
Left-hand hitter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. And he boots it. Runner from second crosses the plate. And it's 8-4.
Just a bloop hit behind third right there, and that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to, and the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there.
First and second, two down. And now it's going to be Cody Bellinger at the belt and fires. That to right. And that's a base hit. Hoerner flies around third. He will score. It's down 9-4.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a long dart in there, and he found a way.
First and third, two away. And now the right fielder, Seiya Suzuki. That's inside, and it's 2-1. Corners are occupied with two down. This one in the air, right field. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double. A run comes in on the play.
The automatic double kind of feels like enjoying cruise control in your car, Boog. You don't need to keep the pedal down as you cruise into second base.
New pitcher for the Marlins, number 20.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Dansby Swanson is going to get a chance to hit. Check swing. He won it. That is strike two.
Two strike.
Bellinger at third. Suzuki on at second with two down. On the ground. Arise on to first. And they're happy to just get off the field after that frame. So a great inning there as they bat around to score six times to open up the lead. Through eight full, it's the Cubbies 10 and the Marlins 4. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Julian Merriweather.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Jesus Sanchez getting ready to hit.
The right fielder, Jesus Sanchez.
Kicks and deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. That's hard hit on the line. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
These hitters today are so great with handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
So now the DH spot, Avisail Garcia. And Garcia gets a piece.
If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
Man at second. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Right-hander kicks, deals.
Three.
Struck him out looking.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously. So he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
Now, Christian Bethencourt. Swing and a miss. And a count. 1-2.
2 strikes.
Just misses with that one. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. One out and a runner at second. Righty to the plate. That misses, and the count is filled up. In the air, right field. Suzuki has a beat on it. Calls it in for the out. And there's two away.
The batter number three, second baseman, Luis Arraez.
So it's their last chance in this one. Now it's the second baseman, Luis Arraez. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers. Bounce to third. Throw to first. Ball game. And the Cubs take this one in a blowout.
Yeah, pretty tight ball game up until the eighth inning, and that's really the time where you expect things to lock down. But the offense broke out, incredible outburst, and just put this game out of reach.
10-4 is how it ends. Roger Dodger, ground beef control. The Cubs go home a winner. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Shambi saying so long.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 10 runs, 12 hits, no errors.